The Quran has to be proven, you know, to be true rationally. So there's all these books written making rational proofs of why it's revelation. There's all these, because they needed to ground it in that. And so I think that's foundational to the understanding that you had to have faith and reason, and that component was so important. And also, there's no verses in the Quran where any coercion is mentioned. The Quran states clearly in chapter 18, فَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيُؤْمِنْ وَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيَكْفُرْ. Whoever wants to believe, let him believe. It literally says, فَلْيُؤْمِنْ, let him believe. And whoever wants to disbelieve, فَلْيَكْفُرْ, let him disbelieve. And then the Prophet Muhammad, it was said to him, in the Quran, can you compel people to be believers? In the second chapter of Baqarah, it says that there can be no coercion in the religion. That reason is clear from unreason or error. That, you know, the reason, it's clear, this is clear. So you can't force people, let them think about this. Even in the chapter where they say about killing people in Surah At-Tawbah, which is the ninth chapter, and this is always quoted by people saying that Islam is violent. It says to kill the polytheists wherever they are. And that verse, which is in that chapter, that verse was a time-specific verse because the polytheists had broken the treaty with the Muslims. They had a treaty, and they had broken it by killing Muslims. And then they went to Mecca, which was a sanctuary at that time, and they had captives, and it was permission to fight in the sanctuary. That was not a universal thing to, I mean, isn't this what you were taught? You know, this is what we were taught. And then it says immediately after that, but if one of them wants to hear the word of God, let him hear the word of God. And then it says, and if he decides not to believe, then take him to a safe place and leave him alone. Right? So, you know, this is this decontextualization and the idiotic people, you know, quoting. I mean, I had one of my teachers, somebody got up in a lecture and quoted this verse in the Quran that says, whoever doesn't judge by God, he's a disbeliever. And he said to him, which chapter is that in? He said, I don't know. And he said, what was the verse before it so I can know the context? He said, I don't know. He said, what was the verse after it? He said, I don't know. He said, what do you do? He said, I'm a mechanic. He said, fix cars. I mean, we, you know, like I said, you know, these books are dangerous books. And you have to have a scholastic tradition that is able to navigate these meanings. So, you know, the Prophet ﷺ never, nobody during his lifetime was killed for apostasy, nobody. And there are apostasy laws, just like in Catholicism, you can find in church canon law, you can find apostasy laws. There are apostasy laws. There's one hadith that they base these on, but there are other hadiths, and they weren't in agreement upon this. One of the greatest scholars of Islam, Atta, did not believe that there should be any capital offense in apostasy.